It is hot! Oh my gosh! Well, let's see if Dusty starts. It's been about 3 to 4 days since I started her, so let's see how she starts on E. That fuel pump loud though. Yes, yes sir. You're responsible, boys. Welcome back to another video, man. Hopefully you guys can hear me well. It's, you know, to be honest, this is like my third time ever recording like this. Like with my actual camera that I used to record videos and not my GoPro. I usually like to do those POV videos because they seem like cool. I'm gonna do it this way because it seems cool. So in today's video, man, I wanted to share my experience with being on flex fuel. Hold on, something to pull. I just wanted to share my experience being on E85, 93, being on flex fuel, that's what it's called. I want to tell you guys what I feel, if you guys should actually buy the kit, or if you guys should just go straight 93 tune or straight E85 tune, what like issues I had, or if I had any issues, the benefits, because boy, the benefits are like, benefits are up there. What the hell was that? Also, yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't really know what else to tell you guys about. Hopefully you guys can hear me well. I am trying to scream because I know Dusty is loud, but I can't fix that unless I get some quiet songs, which I'm not gonna do anytime soon. Ooh, there's some nice cars driving by. Woo! But yeah, man, let's start with the first thing. How am I doing with the car? How's the E85 in the car? Has it ate through my lines yet? Yada, yada, yada. So I've been on E85 for roughly, I guess you could say, a month now. It's lovely because I don't have to worry about, I mean, not worry about anything. It's lovely because I have that extra top end when I use E85. Also, the price of E85 is really, really cheap. Like, stupid cheap. I pay to fill up my tank. I think the 9th gen tank is like 13 gallons or 12 gallons. For me to fill up my tank on full E85 is 25 to 27 dollars to fill up my whole tank. Bro, when I tell you I feel like I found a cheat code to life, bro, it's so nice being able to fill up my tank. With straight 85, I only spent $25, $27. Usually on 93, for me to do that, I'll spend up to close to $50 since gas prices are crazy right now. Yo, my guy, you're in my lane, my guy. What's wrong with this guy, man? But yeah, like I was saying, it's lovely because I don't have to spend too much. And if I was on 93, I'll probably be spending close to $50 every time I wanted to fill my tank up, like completely on 93, a 12-gallon tank. So the cost is lovely. Only downfall is it does burn faster than 93, like way faster. They say it's 30% faster, but if you don't drive your car a lot, or your distance until your job is a couple miles, it's not that bad. But that's when the flex fuel kit does come in handy, because I can just switch to 93 like that and have no issues with my tune or anything. It'll, you know, the tune will compensate and it'll adjust the timing, yada, yada, yada. I'm not a tuner, so I can't explain all that. But if it adjusts everything and my car runs like it was just, you know, like it's regular, like I'm not on a whole different mixture of gas, which is nice, which is really, really nice. And for drivability and like daily driving, that's the main reason why I went with this kit, the SIRIMOTO kit, just because I could switch gases like that. Now the kit is kind of pricey. You can do it cheaper and get the innovative kit, but I just wanted to just get the kit on and not have to worry about wiring different things and fixing different things up. Ooh, that's a clean looking Infiniti right there. But yeah, I didn't want to worry about doing all that stuff, so I just bought the SIRIMOTO kit. Hopefully I'm not too dark on camera for you guys. Ooh, why is everybody braking so damn hard? plug and play with everything. One thing I had to wire, I didn't wire anything. Everything was plug and play. And if you guys want to check out that video, I'll put the link right here. But yeah, everything was just plug and play. One thing that's a pain in the butt is just wiring the wires through your from your center console to your firewall into your engine bay. That's probably the only thing that's a little annoying, because you have to wire it through the little small grommet, and you don't really have too much space. Why this car just sitting next to me? After that, the kit's good. The innovator kit, from what I've seen, is a little bit more technical. You have to do a little bit more wiring, and you have to figure out how you want to route everything and stuff like that. But after that, it's basically the same thing, but a cheaper price. So another reason why I want to go E85 so bad is because it runs way cooler than 93, 87, whatever other gases that you could buy directly from the gas station. It runs way cooler than those, and it's way cheaper, as you guys already know. Do I think it's worth it? Do I think you should get it? It all depends on you and your budget. I say if you got it, go for it, bro, because you're going to love it. It's going to be so nice for you to just want to switch, just put in some E85, and then go on a long road trip and put in some 93. So, yeah, bro. It's all depending on your budget, what's your goal for your car. You could have your car running on E85 for the whole life of it if you want. But knowing me, I know that I'm eventually going some long trips, or some days I'm not going to be able to find an E85 gauge. Find the E85 gas station, so I'm gonna have to be limited to just getting 93. And I don't want to have to have that issue where people, I know some people who have 10 gallon tanks, like jugs, in the back of the car filled up with E85 just in case they run out of E85 on a long trip. I don't want to be one of those people who has to do that. So yeah, that's another reason why I wanted to get E85. Plus, it cleans your engine, to be honest. It really does. It cleans your heads, cleans your block, a lot of stuff. E85 is amazing in my eye. Got a little ZOOVIE behind me. I don't know if he's trying to play. But it's something that I really like, and I recommend everybody, if you can get it, to get it. Because you're going to like it a lot. So I already know you guys are probably wondering, like, what's the issues I had. I didn't have any issues, to be honest. The kit been on for a month or two by now, I say. Yeah, it should be like 2 months now. But I've been on E85 for a month, and no issues with the kit, no leaks, no nothing. Gauges work fine. Have no problem at all with the car. Car runs good, smells good. It just operates good. The kit is fine. All I'm gonna say is make sure you keep everything away from heat, and keep everything away from stuff that moves, and it should be fine. Like, I always check my, I don't know about you guys, but I check my engine bay every drive just to make sure nothing's out of like place and out of whack. So me doing that, I always ensure that my car is fine. But I know there's some people out there who just hop in the car and just drive and don't even like check to see if, you know, if anything's in the way. But obviously, if your car is stock, you never move anything. Nothing should be out of place as well.
Pretty dope for a tuner.
Gonna give you guys a quick little pull. But yeah, man, if you guys are really thinking about getting an E85 flex fuel kit or just a flex fuel kit, I don't know why it's E85. Do it, bro. You won't regret it. Don't listen to people say, you're not going to make no power on the money. You're not going to do this. You're not going to do that. Don't listen to them. Do what the hell you want. If you're going to do it, bro, do it. I recommend you do it. It's nice to have that flexibility that you can put E85, E55, E65, you know, just any type of e-gas in your car. And your tune is fine. You stick a bang gears and all that stuff. It's lovely. I love it. And it saves me a lot of money because I don't have to put $50 in my tank. But yeah, man, if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, follow your boy Instagram at _gotsoda. Make sure you guys go check out the links down below, and your boy